Hey folks, we're back. Sorry for that. You're gonna notice when we jump back in that we are in a slightly different place than where we left off. Basically, when I tapped out to deal with Fraps, the game locked up and then crashed, so I had to run through some stuff again. It wasn't anything important. It autosaved fairly close to where we had left off, so it's like maybe 5 or 10 minutes of gameplay, no big deal. Anyways, we are now ready more or less to go and cause chaos in Chinatown, but first we're going to talk to Isaac, and I'm going to see if there's any side quests that we have yet to deal with. I think there may be a couple. Like, I know we still have to deal with that one restaurant. I don't know what we're going to be doing there, but we got to do that. And then I know we've got some, like, we still have the pier, which I don't know how to go about that. So that's probably going to get just kind of put off. I think that's about it. I can check here real quick. We have 4 experience points. Hollywood. Find this by Barabbas. Alright, we have to go through the cafe and do that. And then defeat the Samiti, and we have to tell Isaac about that. Prince wants a sarcophagus. Tin Can Bill in the direction of the sewers. Yeah, the plague bearer. I don't know what's up with that. And then we have the pier where we can't do anything. We mailed the blood to LaCroix. And we have to go to Skyline appointments. Yada yada yada. Instead, he heard another message detailing Durbin. And let me meet someone at an unknown location across the street from a bar. Okay. Don't even remember that one. Like, I remember what led up to it, but I have no idea what it's in relation to. First thing we're gonna do is find Isaac and let him know what's going down, though. Metalhead Industries. What if we can... Ah, locked. Darn. Hey, cab dude. Yeah. Ground Zero. There's actually a quest that starts in Ground Zero, but it's kind of convoluted and I don't want to deal with it. You gotta kind of like trace networks and stuff. It's a pain in the ass. Okay, hello.
More flatbread and olive oil. And take back the Chardonnay and open up a Chianti. Let it breathe for 20 minutes and then bring it out with a ziti. Okay?
I just wanted to...
Wanted to know what? Interrupt me while I'm working? Do you understand that this is an important opening and I, emphasize I, am going to make or possibly break this restaurant?
Just who exactly are you to feel you have so much power?
Me, Tommy Flayton. The Food Authority of Los Angeles, food critic for the biggest paper on the West Coast, radio personality for the KTLK, Chower Hour. Maybe if I reviewed more pancake huts, you'd know me.
Just the man I wanted to talk to.
I'm not sure exactly what you mean.
Isn't it in your best interest to pan this place? You've got a reputation to keep.
How so?
You're becoming the joke of the food world. You'll give anything a good review.
You know, now that you mention it, the gnocchi was a bit cold, and the ravioli might have been store-bought. Also, the decorum's a bit lacking, isn't it? This place is just an overpriced cafeteria. No stars! Yes. I'm going to write a review that will destroy this restaurant.
Good, good. I'll be leaving now that my work is done. Good night. So I suppose we eventually have to go and tell LaCroix that we did that one of these days. But first, we shall talk to Isaac. He seems like a good guy. A respectable vampire, not a twat waffle like a certain blonde-haired douchebag.
Evening. Evening.
Kingsway, there was a Samitsi. Notice I've used past tense.
Exceptional. Come by in a little while. I should have something for you then.
I'll stop by to pick it up later. Thanks, Isaac. Okay, so I guess we're gonna go to Chinatown. See what kind of horrors await us therein. Should be, interesting. I always like that place. Seems like there should be like a quest there or something. Lucky Star. The Augur Resources. There's all these signs for buildings, and you can't go into any of them. Except for the red spot.
Where to?
Away from here. Take me to Chinatown. Sure, of Cain have spread throughout the world, but they find themselves thwarted in the Far East by the mysterious Quaid Jenner. Kathian, non-kindred vampires native to the Orient. Alright. We're gonna save. Let's see here. Save. Yes. Alright, we are at Chinatown. We're gonna kind of poke around a little bit and see if we can't find anything of interest. Not looking like it, so we'll just head right on in. We're gonna get killed, I know it. The dragon, the red dragon. I seem to recall we were looking for a temple. I like this one. I could go for some ramen. Who likes me some noodles?
Hey you! You want your fortune, Red? You give me $5, I give you secret Chinese enlightenment. Only stupid person not want to know future.
Sure, why don't you tell me my future?
$5.
I don't have $5, apparently.
Oh, you want fortune for free? Okay, here go. You will get job in future. Probably making French fry. You will come back with burger money and pay for real fortune. Don't waste my time.
I like this man. I seriously don't have $5, though. Where's my wallet? I seriously don't have $5. Damn. Need to find a pawn shop and sell some shit. Woeful modern development, thin-blooded kindred have appeared in recent years. It's a can of tuna. Another can of tuna. Hey look, a piece of candy. A piece of candy. A piece of candy. A piece of candy. Okay. I assume you are the woman I want to talk
Welcome,
to.
Welcome, kindred. And thank you for respecting our traditions by announcing your presence in our domain. I am Ming Zhao, High Priestess to the people of Chinatown. Can I get you anything? Tea, perhaps?
I'd rather, we'll be polite. No tea, thank you.
Ah, that is right. Your kind drinks solely of mortal blood, correct? No longer may you partake in the simple pleasures of the mortal realm. A shame.
You can?
Yes. We Kuei Jin are similar to you kindred in fewer ways than you might imagine.
You are vampires, right?
We are supernatural. That does not mean we are like yourself. We are beings returned through the second breath for a purpose.
Second breath?
The second breath, our rebirth into the supernatural form. It is a spiritual awakening, not some lowly blood ritual meant to spread a despicable curse.
I like how she keeps insulting us. But we are similar.
We share superficial similarities. Kuei Jin feed on essences that can be found in blood, yes. But as we refine our existence, rarely are we lowered to consume the bodily fluids of others.
Oh, so I'm some lowly blood-licking dog?
Oh no, dear kindred. You misunderstand me. I mean no disrespect.
Disrespect this. There you go. So as a mortal you chose to become supernatural?
No, we do not choose. But events of our lives can awaken dark spiritual energies. We are not born of the whims of another as the kindred are.
So why are some chosen to become supernatural?
The reasons are as numerous as the Kuei Jin themselves. Each is reborn with a purpose that they must find. Once their path is evident, they must seek to fulfill it, even if it takes eternity.
It sounds as much of a curse as the embrace of Cain.
On the contrary, it is another chance for us to find our place in the universe. A chance for transcendence. We are not damned, not burdened with an ancient guilt. as in the legend of your biblical progenitor.
Speaking of legends, have you heard of the Incarn sarcophagus?
Of course. The entire city is alight with news of its arrival and speculation about one of your ancient vampire grandfathers and his evil apocalyptic plot.
I take it you don't believe in that.
Kuei Jin do not share your history, nor do we share in your false prophecies.
It all does seem rather silly, doesn't it?
It all serves to distract the kindred. Such a distasteful existence you live, skulking in the shadows, fighting for scraps and fearing the return of your fictitious fathers, completely oblivious to your true purpose.
She's a very emotive woman. Let's see. Do you know where the sarcophagus is?
We seek it, of course. I have two of my best agents looking. It could be a powerful bargaining tool.
Who are these agents?
Let me just say that I do not encourage you to seek the Ankaran sarcophagus.
I have a few more questions.
What can I help you with?
I am looking for a missing Nosferatu.
So, the great Nosferatu have lost an agent, have they? It was not by my hand, if that's what they think.
Do you have any idea where he could be?
I don't know where he is. Perhaps you should speak with Wong Ho about this.
Who is Wong Ho?
Wong Ho owns the Red Dragon Restaurant. He's a prominent businessman who has garnered much respect among his people. If something is amiss in Chinatown, he may know how to help you.
I'll head down to the Red Dragon.
I grant you permission to operate in the Kuei Jin domain. For now, may you find your path, kindred.
Thanks. Okay, let's get out of here. And we saw the Red Dragon coming in, so we know where that is, at least. I think I might want to poke around a little bit, though. See about hawking somewhere. Okay. That was, interesting. I suppose we could go check that out. Let's see. Prep our trans. Ready the gat. Glock. Got a Glock 9. Well, we could get up there if we wanted to. Not seeing a reason to, though. What are you doing? I wonder what the hell those guys were up to. Some carrying a person, so I assume they had ill intent in mind, but I'll be damned if I know where they got off to. Excuse me. Are they out here? No. Excuse me, sir. I know if you're not careful, you can get attacked by, vampire hunters out here. So, not entirely sure that I want to be kind of poking my nose into everything here. But I'm going to do it anyways. Huh. Okay. Well, that's an interesting little waste of time. I like the skylights, though. Pretty cool. Whatever those guys got off to, I do not know. Where are we? Okay. I know where we are. We're right out front. Not as lost as I thought I was. So Red Dragon, yes. Ha ha! And Sang's right across the road. The Book of Nod, a loose collection of kindred legendary and history. Okay. Hello?
I'm sorry. Dinner service stopped a little while ago. But our lounge is still open.
I'm here to see Wong Ho. Ming Zhao sent me.
I'll get the elevator.
Second floor,
have a good night.
Goodbye. Ooh, fancy. Claustrophobia.
No, I'm still at work. I don't know. Why would I want to rush home right away? Yeah, I do like that. What else? With a what? Oh, you're in the kitchen. Yeah, they were on sale, so I bought some. You did too, like zucchini.
Wow. Assume he's through here? No. Is he in here? Yes.
They took her.
Yeah, I know, I saw. What happened?
Kiki, my daughter. They grabbed her. They called and said, Wong Ho has meddled with Tong for the last time.
This might not be the best time, but Ming Zhao sent me to talk with you.
Ming Zhao? Oh, of course. Please forgive me, but as you can see, I am in a most terrible situation. I am Wong Ho, owner of the Red Dragon. Again, I apologize for my inconsiderate behavior.
No problem. What's going on here, Wong Ho?
The Tong. A local street gang here in Chinatown just broke into my restaurant and kidnapped my daughter at gunpoint. The Tong grow more bold every day, and now they have my Kiki.
That makes Daddy angry. Do you know where she is? I'll go get her.
No. The Tong have many... wait. Please excuse me a moment. Hello. Zhao. Huh? Yes. How did you... Of course. I see. Thank you, my friend. Your debt has been repaid 1,000 times over. Yes. Of course. Goodbye.
That didn't sound like the Tong.
That was someone who owed me an old debt. It has been repaid. I know where the Tong are keeping my daughter.
Just tell me where, and someone better call the coroner.
Kiki is being held at the Lotus Blossom, a massage parlor here in Chinatown. If you bring her back to me, I will help you in any way that I can.
Of course I'll bring her back safely.
Thank you. I shall wait here until you return. Strike fast. The Tong will not be expecting anyone so soon. Good luck, my friend.
See ya. Alright. Looks like we're finally gonna get back to fighting some humans again, which means they're sorely outmatched. Even though I may be somewhat outnumbered. First floor! Go! Alright, we're gonna save just to be safe. Save, yes. And we've got about 12 minutes left, so that should give us enough time to cause some chaos. And we're being emailed! Oh, Jesus! I'm gonna guess that this is the Lotus Blossom on account of there being a Lotus Blossom on the sign and it saying Lotus Blossom. Looks like we're going in! Let's just see how outmatched these guys are. Hello. I want a massage. I cannot talk with you, apparently. Well, in that case, I'm just gonna combine the register here, trance you, and nom 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 nom. Apparently he doesn't speak any English. I will not make a sucky sucky $5 joke in here. Oh, so bad. Oh god. They got firearms of some sort, and I'm going to have to kill them all. Yeah. Boom. No. Ooh, some nice Glocks. I mentioned I like this rifle. Ow. What are you even trying? Where are you? Oh! You cheeky motherfucker. Grenade, I would so clear this whole place. Well, that was easy. Wow, a tire iron. That is some sophisticated weaponry right there. Okay, we'll head down. Clear the basement. Lord knows what kind of horror story is awaiting us down here. Probably a laundromat. Or not. Some dude just chillaxing in the pool. You just carry on with your chillin'. Can't talk to you or anything, can I? No. Yeah, you just chill out and I won't have to explode your head. Okay, any of these openable? Ah, of course. Aw, empty. Any of these? No. Anything lootable. No. Also no. Okay, so I'm gonna guess that this is like the back door if you want to be all sneaky like. Kato is not a sneaky man. If I wanted to be sneaky, I'd play a Malkavian. Those bastards are so freaking stealthy. It's insane. Okay, guess we're going up. But I hear you saying, Gene, you should clear the first floor. And I'm like, I know, but I'm really not afraid of anybody in here. So I'm just going to kind of run roughshod over the place, killing everyone that gets in my way. Well, hello. Thank you, convenient padlock key. I wonder what you open. Okay. Well, that's just... That's why I'm letting you out.
What? Are you a little tall for a tongue?
What?
Tall. You know, like, not short. Jesus. All you thugs are the same. Stupid, stupid, and stupid.
I'm not a thug. Are you Kiki?
Yeah, I'm Kiki. Who the hell are you? The Tong Welcoming Committee?
I'm here to rescue you. Your dad sent me in.
Oh, I'm so impressed. What? Like, you want me to thank you or something? In your dreams, asshole.
Let's just get out of here.
That's an original idea. Man, Dad must really be hurting for good help. Lead the way, hero.
Follow me. And we're gonna save, because I believe she can die if I'm stupid, and I do tend to be stupid, so we want to keep her as alive as possible. Unless she really annoys me, in which case I'm going to blast her in the face with my rifle, which will be hilarious. Okay, guess we're just going to go right on out the front door then. Simplicity! Well, there we go. She is still with me, right? You rescued her, though you feel like killing her instead. I should go back to Long Hill and collect his offer of help. Okay, so she's safe, that means. Which means we're going to go back in and paint the walls of this place with the internals of every living being within. Should be entertaining. Okay. Let's see if we can find any more loot in here. Why, hello there. I'll just grab a bite to eat. Don't kill the innocent hookers, they've done nothing. In fact, they're probably not even really hookers. Masseuses that are scantily clad. This place is dingy as hell. Also dingy as hell. Already been in there. Ah. Okay. Might as well stow our gun, because there doesn't appear to be anybody wanting to kill us here. And if we bump into anybody, we're going to trance them and erase their face. That's unsurprising. That's disgusting. Wow. And there's one there too. Okay. Just looking for any stealable objects, and it does not look like there are any. Alas. Not even a matchbook for my trouble. I'm just gonna trance you again because I don't like you. You may not speak the English, Chinese man, you. I'm shaking my fist at the monitor right now, but you can't see that. Okay, let's go back and talk to Wong Ho. And reminisce about how he didn't put a bullet the size of my fist into his daughter's brain. Excuse me. Spontaneous hiccups. Elevator.
Was there something else?
Oh yeah, I'm here to see Wong Ho.
Have a good night.
Thank you. Creepy elevator doors. Come on. There we go.
Hey, Andrea.
Oh my God.
No, he's not. Hold on, Andrea. I've got another call. Hey, Serena. Did you hear about Joe? And yes, he is. Yes, he is. I know. I was just on the phone with Andrea, and I was all, no, he's not. Yes, he is.
Oh, my God.
Ah, welcome, my friend. I owe you a debt of gratitude. You have returned to me my greatest treasure. Kiki told me how you rescued her. You are a man of great courage and honor. Thank you.
Oh, it's no big. That's the least I could do. Now, can you help me?
Of course. What can I help you with?
You see, it burns when I... I'm looking for someone who's gone missing in Chinatown.
Who is this person?
His name is Barabbas. He's, a business associate.
What else can you tell me about him?
He's in surveillance technologies, computer geek.
I see. I do not think I could find him for you, but I know someone who could.
Yeah? Who?
His name is Zhao. He is the man who called me and told me where Kiki was being held. Zhao has many connections. He owns an import-export warehouse in Chinatown. Go and see him there. I will call ahead and tell him to expect you.
Thanks, Wong Ho. I appreciate it. Alright, we've got about a minute and a half left, give or take a couple minutes, because of the whole crash thing, and I wasn't really paying attention to the time, so we'll go talk to this guy and see what he wants. No elevator music. Seriously, go down. Okay, import-export business. I think we saw that place, actually, while we were out gallivanting around trying to find those people that stole his daughter. So we will go this way, and I'm gonna save, I think. Yes, okay. The Lotus Blossom. Okay. Is that like a... Oh, looked like he was holding a gun. Which he was not. And I think I'm gonna go through here and around here. I think. I know you're practicing your craft, lady, but whatever. Strange. Zhao's imports. I'm guessing this is where we wanna be. So we're gonna go in and meet Zhao. Wonder if he's an admiral. Another 5 points if you get that reference. Okay, I'm gonna guess he's up there waiting for us.
Wong Ho called. You're looking for someone.
Yes, that's right.
I don't know where your friend is, but I know the Tong are involved. The leader of the Tong, Johnny, he'll know where they are.
And where do I find Johnny?
Johnny's at Glaze. It's his club. You'll need a password to enter. The password is 725. There will be Tong everywhere. Johnny's office is upstairs.
Thanks. Why are you helping me?
I am a man of my word, and I owe the debt to Wong Ho. By paying that debt, I have made an enemy of the Tong, who I once belonged to.
What are you gonna do now?
You should leave now.
We know it was you!
Looks like entertainment just arrived.
Excuse me.
Oh, I think he's got a really big gun. Dude, it's not worth it. Seriously. And you better not just kill him. Nope, you didn't. He is. Yeah! I love that revolver. Open the door. Open the door. Open the damn door! There we go. She needs cover. Oh noes! Oh, Colt Anaconda, you are mine. And you guys are so fucked. Oh. And I guess. Oh man. All of that. See, I think we have some blood on us. Yes, yes. Okay, so that's a good bit of healing. Alright, where'd that fool go? There he is. Yep. I know there's one more of them out here, though. At least I think there is. Ha ha ha, there is! I am the darkness, I am the night, I'm Batman. Diddy. Diddy. Oh, there we go. Not feeling well? Here, let me give you a nice enema. Oh shit! The enema was a poor choice! Okay, okay, we got this. Blood heal. Bullet. Reload. Alright, where are you? Oh, there you are. Boom! Pop aspects and blood strike. There we go. I think there's. Okay, there's two left. Two I can deal with. Now there's one left and he's totally fucked. Oh, there's another one. Oh, there's two more. Ah! I hate this thing, but it works. This guy, he doesn't even know. Oh, you are so going to be my healing potion. Nom 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 nom. Well, that worked. Suppose I should probably tell Wong Ho about his Wang Wong Ho, whatever the hell his name is. We should probably tell him about his buddy getting pasted by these fools. And see, I think we should be good. So, I'm going to save it And I think we're going to call it an episode here, folks. So, as per usual, thank you very much for watching, and I will see you folks next time.